was working recently with a customer who wanted to loop through their OneDrive files. So for example, if I go into my files on OneDrive and I go into workshop data, and let's say I wanted to loop through the files here and kind of bring them into ClickSense. The customer was saying that unfortunately in our help page, you would see that there is no ability to loop through files, meaning you can use the wildcard in the actual syntax. One way to get through that is, I'm going to show you that right now. I'm going to create an actual application where I loop through these files here, and you're going to see how easy that is to do. So coming into a application, go to script editor, you're going to see me do this. So first things first, very straightforward. You should first of all create a connection, and you can see that there's a OneDrive metadata connector. Once you've set that up, I already set mine up, right? Super straightforward. You authenticate, you're good. Once that's set up, now you should have in your list of connectors, and I've built my sales connector and my OneDrive connector right there. So I'm going to create a new section and call this loop through, right? So first things first, there's this website, a community. Someone has actually done most of the work for us. So we're going to be taking advantage of the hard work our colleagues have done and use that here. So I'm going to copy this entire code, paste it right here. First, the libconnect file, I need to change this because this is his OneDrive. I'm going to make it mine. So the way you do that, super straightforward. So now that's my libconnection. Everything else I like, but I need a driver. I need a drive ID, and the path here should be in my path. Once that's done, most of it is almost there. Okay. So for the drive ID, pretty straightforward. What I do is if I go into my OneDrive, open this on the drives, right? If I hit preview data, I get to see my drive. I right click that and copy that drive ID. That's what I need. So this is my account related to me. I'm going to paste that right in here. First things first. Now, secondly, make sure there are no spaces. Folder ID, right? Because like I mentioned, I would like to get to this folder location, workshop and iterate files. I could either, for this folder ID, go back in here. And now that I know the driver ID, go under items, paste the driver ID there, and preview data, and it's going to give me all the list of all the folders. And I could go in and find a folder and then copy that. Or this option lets me also, after writing the drive ID, I can just write the folder path. And you see there's an example of how this can be done. In my case, it looks like this. It's going to be workshop data and then iterate files. So this is the folder location I need to get to, workshop data, iterate files. Let's see this do this. So for that workshop data, and then iterate files. And I did find that it's not really case sensitive. So in my OneDrive, the I is capitalized. Here, you see it's not really, doesn't really care that it's capitalized or not. So that's a good thing. So once that's done, I like what I see. I'm gonna hit select that, and this is gonna write the code for me. It's gonna insert. And now that's my script. What I would like to do is here, paste this new, you know, code right up there. But what I'm doing actually here, what this has done is this has actually created the exact items I need. But all I need is just this path file. So I'm just going to copy this and paste this right here. So far, so good. Again, I don't really need this entire code because I'm doing the exact same thing at the top. Okay, so I'm going to cancel X out of that. So now I have the workshop and not all of that. The last thing is I need to change this from statement, and I'm going to make that super quick. So I need to make this something that's more relevant to the Excel workbooks because that's what these files are, right? I'm going to bring those right in. I'm going to go the way to do that. I bring just one sample copy of the files, markshop data. Oh, enter files, I'm just gonna bring one of these files right in here and then paste it here. And in fact, that's it there. It's a script, so I just want this lib statement. I'm gonna create a new let v file string equal, right? Because I want this to be this value, right? And this is what I'm gonna add in my statement at the end in this, and then I'm just gonna append this v file to the end of my statement right there. Pretty straightforward, because I'll be expanding, I'll be doing expand here. I don't need to do another expansion here. So this entire value, your path file, is not represented in this v file string. So now what I've done, right? And then the other thing is, we see that this is referring to a particular table, and this logic also should be replaced right here. So now all I need, all is good. You notice all is good. Rather than call it sales files, I want the table names to come with whatever tables have been brought in. One thing you would see is, once I run this code, there's going to be a lot of synthetic keys, and that's fine. And I'll explain why. That's because of this file name here. So now this is doing is looping through that folder, bringing in all the files. And like I said, the synthetic key is going to come through, but that's fine. I'll explain why that is. So if I open up the data model viewer, what you'd see is all the tables brought in from this subfolder are going to have a field name called file name, right? File name is now a field name in all of them. And that's as expected, because we saw that, right, in our code. And again, it's what I expected. So if I just comment this out, all should work now. So now I'm about to now loop through and bring in every table from my iterate files subfolder in my OneDrive folder location, and good to go. No more synthetic keys. This looks good. Everything is related because Qlik is associative engine is super smart. And that's it. Six tables, 3, 4, 5, 6 from here. All right.